بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we send salutations upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Continuing from yesterday, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hashr, amazing verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us advice, advice that is thought-provoking, advice that instills in anyone a huge amount of consciousness and realization and remembrance. Allah says, O you who believe, subhanallah, O you who believe, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ittaqullah, fear Allah. What does it mean to fear Allah? Taqwa. Taqwa means caution. One who is cautious. One who is cautious, because when a person has taqwa, he is aware of Allah, he is conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna rabbaka labil mirsad, your Allah is in ambush. What does it mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you more closely than your enemy would have seen you while he is in ambush looking at you. Allah sees you. You know, when an enemy is in ambush and is watching you, he is obviously watching you with the intention of harming you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in ambush, not to attack you, but rather his knowledge of every movement of your body, every movement of your limb, every movement of your heart, every thought of your mind. يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. He knows what is hidden. He knows what is even more hidden. He knows the secret and that which is even softer than the secret, that which is more hidden than the secret. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lamu kha'inat al-a'yun wa ma tukhfi as-sudur. He knows the deception of the eyes. When a person is misleading someone, or a person is acting in deceit, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the gazes of one's eyes. وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ, and what is hidden inside the depths of one's heart. Sometimes a person doesn't know what he is thinking and he doesn't realize what he is doing, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, be aware of Allah. اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Be aware of Allah. Be conscious of Allah. Be wary of the fact that Allah is watching. اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَلْتَنْدُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ. And every soul should prepare for tomorrow. A soul should look to what it prepared for tomorrow. Not prepare, but look at what you have prepared. In other words, take account of yourself. Take account of your life and look at your life and what they call and meditate over what you have done and over what you have prepared for the Akhirah. What you have prepared, Allah doesn't say for the Akhirah. Allah says for tomorrow. For tomorrow. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, time in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so quick. This world is so quick. Even to us it will seem so short when we reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says this in the Quran, and they will say, illa bithum illa ashra, and they will say, illa ashiyatan, they only stayed in this world for a morning, or duha, for an evening or a morning, meaning not even a day, this entire world. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, prepare for tomorrow. And then Allah says, wattaqu Allah, again in the same verse, and be wary, have taqwa of Allah. Have taqwa of Allah. Inna Allah khabirun bima ta'amaloon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well informed of what you do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows every single move of what you do. So in other words, gain taqwa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all taqwa. Say ameen, my brothers. And then Allah says something amazing in verse 19, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهِ. And do not be like those who forgot Allah. Do not be like those who forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine the life of someone who doesn't have Allah. What kind of a life? What kind of a person would that turn into? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not be like those who forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then Allah flips it. فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ, and Allah made them forget their own souls. When they forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah made them forget their own souls. Sometimes look around you at the kuffar. Look at how they live. Look at how their daily routine goes. And you wonder, subhanallah, look at these people. Look at these people. They wake up in the morning, go to work, and all for preparation for what? For coming back in the evening and going to sleep. And having a few parties, having a little bit of entertainment, getting themselves consumed by alcohol, intoxicated by alcohol. And this is the lives that so many, the majority of them lead in our midst, if only we can observe. And Allah says, do not be like those who forgot Allah. Allah made them forget their own selves, their own souls. There is no difference between that and an animal. An animal lives for its own daily routine. And you look at this and you wonder, subhanallah, there is no purpose, there is no direction, there is no route that they're following. It's the repetitive action. The one man grows up, he becomes of age, he becomes an adult, he goes out of his father's home, and he goes, and then what he does, he works, and then he meets someone, and then what happens? He may have a child, and the same routine is repeated, and then his children don't want to know him, he doesn't want to know his children. What kind of a life is this? We make shukr for Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah makes them forget their own selves when you forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is not only with the kuffar. You'll see it among people who think they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but look at our lives, look at the lives. Where is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Where is the direction? Allah makes them forget themselves, and their life is a misery. Their life is a life of unhappiness, a life of depression. Because a life without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a depressed life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts. And so amazing, and then we'll just mention one of the verses we recited today before we conclude. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the day of Qiyamah, subhanallah. In Surah Al-Haqqah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks, يَوْمَئِذٍ تُعْرَضُونَ لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَةً. On that day, you will all be presented before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will all be presented before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَةً. Nothing will be hidden. Nothing will be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La takhfa minkum khafiyah. Nothing from you will be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fa amma man utiya kitabahu bi yameenih. And as for the one who's given his book of deeds in his right hand, fa yaqulu ha'u muqra'u kitabiyah. He will jump with joy. He will cry out, ha'u muqra'u kitabiyah. Hey! Even the Arabic says, ha. I'm translating it as, hey, ha, umuqra'u kitabiya. Listen here, read this book of mine. Inni dhanantu anni mulaqin hisabiya. I knew أني ملاقٍ حسابي, that I will one day receive my book, my reckoning.
I was expecting it. I thought
so. ظننت فهم في فهو في عيشة راضية. He will be in a beautiful life, meaning he will go to Jannah. في جنة عالية, in a Jannah which is high. قطوفها دانية. Allah describes Jannah. Its fruits are lowering. Its fruits are facing. Its fruits are reaching. كلوا واشربوا هنيئا بما أسلفتم في الأيام الخالية. And then Allah speaks about the one who will receive his book of deeds in his left hand. فيقول يا ليتني لم أوت كتابيه. He will say, how I wish I wasn't given this book, and I didn't even know my status. How I wish I didn't even know. Today, when you don't know your status, it's worse than knowing it. If you don't know and you're waiting for your exam result, they say waiting is worse than death. It's just the same. You know, you don't know if you failed or passed. This person, once he knows, he says, how I wish I didn't even know. يا ليتها كانت القاضية. How I wish I was dead. I wasn't around. ما أغنى عني مالية. My property, my wealth didn't give me any benefit. هلك عني سلطانية. All my authority has been usurped, has gone away. And then he will be punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah protect us, my respected elders and brothers. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the mujrim. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the mujrim, which is the evildoer. Allah says he will wish on that day. يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ, that he can give away and ransom himself with his children. He can put his children in Jahannam so he can be ransomed. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَأَخِيهِ, even his wife, he will wish that he can trade her and ransom her for his own salvation. وَفَصِيلَتِهِ الَّتِي تُؤْوِيهِ, and with his clan, he wishes that he could free himself. He wishes that he could free himself with anything. Allah says, وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا, even he will choose anyone in the world to sacrifice. The entire world, if he had to choose to sacrifice for his own salvation, he would do so. Allah says, كَلَّا إِنَّهَا لَظَى, but that isn't going to happen, is it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us this is the state of the mujrim. But what about the believer? What about the one who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah says, دَيْ الْأَخِلَّاءُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ. The muttaqoon will be told, لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ, there is no grief upon them, and no should they be fear, and no should they be grieved or disappointed. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who are given the book of deeds in their right hand. Say ameen. Jazakumullah subhanahu wa ta'ala bihamdihi subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika.